think what we're dealing with is a great deal of uncertainty. The only thing that we know for sure is that social movements are going to be far more important than anyone else. Social movements are going to be more important than who's in the Congress, who's in the White House, who's in the Supreme Court, because that's the only way we're going to have to change history. I think one of the things that we've seen very dangerous in the election process and in the coming Trump presidency is that the movement that rose up around his campaign has within it a really almost fascist core of racism, misogyny, xenophobia, Islamophobia. And this is very dangerous if that movement begins to feel that with Trump in the White House, they somehow have power and impunity from accountability, that they have legitimacy that they should never have had and never deserved. It will be even more dangerous. And so our social movements, I think many of us were already preparing for resisting what we anticipated would be a Clinton administration, saying no honeymoon, no waiting, mobilize immediately a movement against wars and escalation. We're still going to have to do that, but now we're going to have to do that, I think, in the context of a broader resistance movement where motion to work to build movements against wars is going to have to also be movements to defend refugees that are trying to come here as a result of those wars. And it's also going to have to link with